रोल नंबर 11 अमित विक्रम। इफ यू डू रिमेम्बर यू आंसर, इफ यू डोंट रिमेम्बर टेल मैम आई डोंट रिमेम्बर, बट इफ यू आर नॉट आंसरिंग एंड पीपल हुम आई एम कॉलिंग आर लीविंग द मीटिंग एवरीथिंग इज ट्रैक्ड इन योर अटेंडेंस लिस्ट यू विल बी गेटिंग माइनस मार्क्स फॉर दैट। अमित विक्रम। रोल नंबर 21 बबीता।
यस मैम, यस मैम, अमित, यस मैम, इट वॉज नॉट ऑडिबल कम्प्लीटली। यस्टरडे मैम यू वर टॉकिंग अबाउट द टाइप्स ऑफ फैब्रिकेशंस,
ओके,
द प्री फैब्रिकेटेड मटीरियल एंड द कंडीशंस इन विच वी डू दैट एंड द डिफरेंट काइंड्स द इक्विपमेंट्स यूज्ड ओवर देयर,
ओके,
द काइंड्स ऑफ इक्विपमेंट्स लाइक क्रेन्स एंड द लिफ्टिंग टूल्स एंड and the fabrication, like if you are building a structure, what amount of the construction work is prefabricated, like it may be partial or it may be fully fabricated,
okay,
based on that some classification were made, like a small prefabrication, medium, and some others were also there, like partial fabrication or total fabrication,
okay,
and then they were explained.
Okay, thank you, thank you Amit. Okay, now let me share my screen. Is the screen visible?
Yes ma'am.
Okay, yes ma'am. Okay, now we'll go see the fabrication process of the prefabricated structures. We have some set of requirements for the prefabrication system where we are in a position to decide our prefabricated system based upon the location, based upon the size of the structure, type of the structure, whether it is small or large or medium, or based upon the classification, whether it is going to be residential or skyscrapers or industrial purpose. Based upon that, we are going to see in detail. Just a minute, let me on my... Okay. Yeah. Yes. Any issues? Is my screen visible?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Thank you. Thank you. Okay. Based upon the reference number of the elements, their locations, dimensions of the elements and weight, location of the reinforcing steel. If your structure is going to be huge, then we'll be having much of reinforcements, connections, liftings and bracings, locations of the embedded items, joining details. These are the basic requirements of the prefabrication system. And we'll see about the process. What are the process? You meanwhile, you'll be having a general idea of how you'll be doing your prefabricated structures. We'll see a quicker recap. That is, we have our formworks ready. Formworks are ready. I mean, our molds are ready. We prepare it. We pour concrete. I mean, we'll embed our reinforcement system, pour the concrete, cure it, remove the, I mean, demolding is done, transported, erected. Yes. This was the process we are seeing for the last two classes. The same we are going to deal in detail now. For the first process is the concreting. Under concreting, what are we going to see is how we are going to assemble the molds. You already know about formwork, shuttering, centering. You all are experts in that. Now we are going to see about the prefabrication system. Everything is going to be inside the factory. All this process is going to happen inside the factory. You will have a horizontal table of continuous formworks fixed. If it is going to be panels, you will have continuous row of panels formwork over there. Side plates also will be fixed. The mold is ready now. Now you are going to prepare the mold. How are you going to prepare the mold? We should make sure that a concrete should not get firmly fixed to the mold. It should be easy to remove. So we have to clean the mold. If it is clean only, our outer finish will be proper. So we have to clean it. And we have to prepare it like using any lubricating oil, or we have to grease it. Only then you can break the tight bond between the concrete and the mold. And fixing of rebars. Now we are going to fix the rebars. Like this is, we'll imagine this is our single mold we'll consider. Now we are going to place our reinforcements here. We are placing our reinforcements here. We should also provide cover, clear cover we have to provide, concrete clear cover we have to provide at the bottom. Only then there will be a gap between the outer surface and the reinforcement. There should be a gap. We provide the gaps, concrete cover blocks wherever required. Our reinforcement is done. Then what we'll do, we'll pour our concrete. A concrete is poured into the entire mold. A concrete is poured and it is filled. After that, we are going to vibrate it using the vibrating tools. Are you all along with me?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Then we are going to vibrate it using the table vibrators. If it is going to be a horizontal structure, then we'll be using our table vibrators. At the bottom of the mold, you'll be having a table vibrator. If you just on the machine, it'll just vibrate. The reason for just vibrating or compacting is in order to remove the air voids present, and you have to prepare a homogeneous mixture. Like one location, maybe in this, imagine at this location, concrete may be poured in excess, whereas in this location, it may be very less. So only if you vibrate this entire mold, after vibrating only, it will spread equally without any voids. And the honeycombs will not be there, proper outer surface will be developed. That's the reason we go for vibrating. And we'll cure it as we saw about the steam curing or the accelerated curing. We cure it, we demold it, and this we'll see. This is a production flowchart in the precast industry. How they'll do is, first we are going to concrete it. This part comes for concreting. What are we going to do? We are going to mix water, fine aggregate, coarse aggregate, and cement. We are going to measure it separately, and we are going to mix it in a mixer bowl. You'll be having a huge mixer bowl in that you are going to mix everything. Meanwhile, your steel and your reinforcements, you are going to cut the steel, going to bend it. You cannot have a straight steel, no? Like you'll be having your bended, you're going to bend it, and you'll be having two parallel reinforcements like this. You are going to bind it using the binding wires. Everything you are going to do simultaneously, it is going to come. Your concrete will be prepared. Your reinforcement is also done. Meanwhile, your mold is ready. You have cleaned the mold. You have fitted the mold ready. You have oiled it. It is prepared. Now, you are going to pour concrete into the, you are going to place the reinforcement. You are going to place the reinforcement, then pour concrete into it. Filling concrete, compacting or either vibrating, and then you have to cure it, demold it, curing in yard. Now, as you're going for prefabricated, you go for a spray type of curing. That is your accelerated curing or either your steam curing. Then once it is done, you remove the, demolding is done, you're curing is done, then you're going for strength check. Once quality and the strength is checked, then you go for dispatch by either road or by rail. All these types of production flowchart has been discussed. Now, we'll see about the process in concreting. Precast concrete elements shall be produced on either horizontal or vertical flat steel surface tilting tables. This is generally prepared in the elements like this. Either if it is going to be a slab, you're going for horizontal. If it is going to be a vertical, then you go for elements like vertical, columns, walls, you go for a vertical thing. If it is going to be a staircase, imagine your staircase, it will be some inclined position. Okay. Prior to casting, electrical conduits and other requirements should be fixed. Yes. In initial olden days, like if you see, if you are residing in a building older than some 30 to 40 years, what they'll do is, first they'll finish the building, they'll construct the building. Once the building is done, then they will bring some electrical connection over the outer surface, and then they'll provide it. If this, imagine this is your fan. I'm sorry, it's really bad drawing in this mouse. Kindly bear with me. Imagine this is your fan. You can observe some extra wirings provided, electrical wirings provided outside. You'll be able to see it. In olden days, this was done. But nowadays, during construction, everything is embedded in the slab itself. Like if you're going for, if you are in the first floor, you want the electrical connections when the second floor roof itself, while casting this itself, electrical conduits provision is available. So you can just insert the wire, you can just push it, you can hang your fan here. Everything is embedded in between your structure. Likewise, inside your prefabricated element itself, you are going to fix this electrical conduits. And steel reinforcement shall be kept in position using adequate spaces to ensure correct position and concrete cover. That is your cover blocks you are going to place. After that, you are going to fix your, you place the reinforcement. Once your, this is the table mold, you place your reinforcements. After your reinforcements are done, now we are going to provide this side shutters. After providing this side shutters, the high quality concrete shall be transported from the batching plant. You have fixed the sides. Now you have prepared it like a box type, the open box type. The top it will be open and the sides will be covered with the formwork. Now we are going to transport the concrete from the batching plant to the to this mold. How we are going to transmit is, you have the transit mixer you have. Through the mixer, you are going to bring it to your work site. Thereafter, concrete shall be carried to mold by gantry crane with the help of the concrete bucket. See, this is the pick where your reinforcements are done at the precast units. It is prepared. You can see continuous. This is for different element and this is for different element. You can see this chains are used. This yellow color indicates your gantry girders, cranes, from which here you can drop your reinforcements. You can fix it. And over that, you'll be having the transit mixer. Your concrete is prepared at some other site. You are bringing it here through this machine. You'll be seeing this machine in your nearby localities where this machine will be, this will be keep on revolving. Have you seen this? It will be rotating always. Which means concrete is inside it, like it should not get set. So it is going on. There are inner blades in between. There will be inner blades which will be mixing the concrete. And once it is brought, you have some girders, this type of girder cranes inside your manufacturing unit. From that, you will be having a concrete bucket source. This, it will be like this type of concrete bucket source. You'll pour this concrete in over here. You can see this is concreted. You can see concrete is getting poured onto the precast slabs. Yes. Process in concreting. During casting, table vibrators, as and when required, shall be used to achieve the best compaction. Top surface can be finished with the hand, the outer finish, that is a top leveling, you can do it with a trowel. Maybe you have already seen how a trowel will literally look like. This will be your trowel. You can level it with it. It will be very sharp so that you can provide a smooth surface. Care should be taken on embedded items while concreting. Therefore, curing shall be carried out as per the specifications required. And now we'll see about the procedure for demolding and how we are going to store it, that is stocking. Lifting of elements from molds, it must be ensured that all the elements should have identification marks. For each and every element, you are going to give some code numbers so that only you'll be knowing how many number of wall items are there, column items are there, how many are casted and how many are yet to be casted. And which wall to be erected in which location. For that, we have to denote it by some identification marks, either using code numbers or using, like, you can give some labels using paints. It must be ensured that all side shutters are loosened. How you are going to demold here is, first you are going to remove the sides. Imagine this is your mold. First you are going to remove the side shutters. You are going to loose it. After losing, you're going to remove it. Then you will have some hooks over it, right? Over that hooks, you'll connect it with your crane and you're going to lift it. Sorry, I'm drawing something and it's coming like a rangoli. I'm really sorry. It must be ensured that all side shutters are loosened so that the elements may be lifted without any damages. Before demolding, it must be ensured that minimum compressive strength is achieved. Also, in the manufacturing unit also, with the same concrete, they'll go and test for cube casting. They'll initially pour concrete into the cube. They'll check by the same accelerated curing. They'll check for the minimum 3 days or the 3, 7, 21 days. They'll check it for the minimum compressive strength. Once it is achieved, then they'll proceed further. The lifting clamps or clutches shall be fixed to the lifting beam at proper positions. Depending upon the size, if your roof slab or your slab panel is very large, then you'll have many number of lifting hook provisions. If you're having a smaller structure, then you'll have either one or two. Then the elements shall be fitted carefully to the stocking area. Now it is going like you're going to lift and place it in the stocking area. The surface of the stocking area, it should be horizontal. It should be horizontal. Only then you can place it in a proper position. If it is going to be in an incline or it is undulated, you cannot place your structure in a proper manner. It may either get tilted or unexpected accidents may occur. Wooden runner shall be placed perpendicular to lifting points and elements are placed over the runners. You place one here, and you place another element here. In between, you are going to place some wooden reapers. In order, like, board should not get in contact, there should be a minimum spacing. In a number of elements per lot should not exceed the man height. If you imagine if a man is standing here, it should not exceed his height. He should have some visual inspection that only then he'll be knowing how many number is there. And we can avoid unexpected accidents there. To avoid that also, we have to keep it limited to man's height. In case of vertical stacking, the gap between the elements should be minimum. Vertical stacking is, you are going to place it like this. This minimum gap, it should be minimum 150 to 200 mm. That is, a cube's size is going to be the minimum size. Stacking shall be done in such a way that slabs of longer span should be placed below the shorter span. Are you all along with me?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, thank you. And this is how you are storing it. I don't know, you place some wooden pieces in between and you are going to store it. You'll be having hooks over everything. It should not damage the other structure. That is also one of the reasons. So you should make sure you are arranging it in a proper thing. And this is for the horizontal members, they are laid like this. For the vertical members, wall panels should be stored vertically and braced in the position of A-frames. This is called A-frames. A-type frames, where you can, here are steel supports with a soffit provided here. It will be very soft. It will not damage your structure. You have this provision, so you fix one over the other. You fix it here and then you place it here. Like simultaneous number of steel racks are there. You can just fix your elements over there. And now how are you going to deliver your components to the work site? Precast elements should be loaded and delivered with the proper supports. Yes, you agree. You have to provide it with proper supports. Also, proper frames, cushionings to prevent transit damage. That's the reason we provide those wooden reapers. And also, surfaces are provided to avoid those clashing of the elements, or it should not tilt. Those things should be kept in mind before delivering it. Delivery should be planned according to general erection sequence to minimize unnecessary occupation of site storage. First, if you are going to erect the columns, then we have to go for only a column erection. Sorry, first, only you can transit your column, then you can transit your slab. If you are not aware of that, you should not take your roof slab first and then you should carry your column. Go base sequence. You know how your structure you're going to build. Base floor, then your beams, slabs, roofs. Like this, you're going to proceed. You have to plan accordingly. You deliver in such a manner. Procedure, any doubts as of now? Okay, fine. Procedure for transportation and erection. And how we are going to transport the precasted elements from the yard to the site. loading of slab over the trailer. Trailer here is nothing but our, which means a long type of tractor, you call it, where you load a heavy equipments or heavy elements you are going to transit. It must be ensured that the identification mark on the slab should be same as per the dispatch list. You should have a dispatch list at the work site. You should make sure that if you are going to carry some 20 numbers, the same 20 are erected at the work site. Any damage occurred during the loading should be informed to the concerned authorities. The lifting clamps or the clutches shall be fixed firmly so that when they are lifting, there should not be any flaws. The lifting beam shall be placed over the precast elements. I am having some disturbances. Kindly mute yourself. The lifting beam shall be placed over the precast elements and ensure that the clutches are locked properly before lifting. Instruction regarding the loading height, positioning, precast elements, and the capacity of the trailer. If the capacity could, if the trailer could carry only about some 3 ton or 4 ton, you should not overload it. Sorry, some 30 ton or 40 ton, you should not overload it. Depending upon the size bearing, I mean weight bearing capacity of the trailer only, you should load it. These are the images where in the inclined position, it is placed. The elements are placed. Here in the vertical positions, this parapet wall positions, those type of elements are being transported. Like they are, it is taken.
What is the clutch here?
Yeah,
ma'am, what is a clutch here? Can you make us see that in the picture?
I'll show you in the forthcoming pictures. And these are the horizontal members where they are taken for transporting. Here you can see the column member. Procedure for transportation and erection, it is getting continued. The wooden rubber shall be placed in between the slab. It the minimum of 500 mm from each end. It should be placed. That is, we already saw in this picture. Wooden rubber. This you should place minimum of in the 500 mm. Some of the precast elements should be placed vertically and transported through a A-frame fixed vehicle, which we already saw. We'll have a A-frame, which means here you are going to transport your vertical elements. If it is going to be horizontal, you can carry a large number of elements. Whereas in case of vertical elements, you have to, if you are placing two elements this side, again you have to place two elements over that side. You have to take it in a balanced manner. Only then, to avoid some accidents, you have to have it in an equal manner. Only then the trailer will be safe to travel. The slab shall be tied firmly to the trailer by means of the belt or rope. You either have the steel chains or you have the belts, ropes, etc. I think the belt you might have seen in yesterday's video. I'll send that video also in the Google Classroom so that you can see it. In that video, you can see the lighter elements are carried using the belts. As moving the load without proper tie, which will cause damage. While transporting elements vertically, the vehicle should be loaded equally on both sides. See, this is, see how they are placing one element and the other side also they are placing another element. This is a component where here it is open for doors. It is being transported in a trailer. Okay. You have no class next, right? You don't have any class after this. Or you have your minors. Do you have class after this? Okay, now we'll see the procedure for unloading of slabs from the trailer to the site yards. From the manufacturing yard, from there you have taken and placed in your trailer. And now from the trailer, how you are going to place it in the site yards. Every slab shall be inspected for the dimensions and the identification mark checked. You have that list from the site, manufacturing unit. You have to cross-verify that before you are unloading your elements. You have to check it and check whether the edges, the corners of the structures and the entire elements are proper. It is quite proper without any damages. The stocking area should be leveled and hard enough for the stocking elements. there should be proper access for the trailer movement. In that locality, you should, this the trailer will be huge, as you might have seen, it will be huge, where it should go and turn. You have to, it will be easy access to be provided, only then you can unload all your elements. In most of the sites nowadays, you have the cranes over there. You will have some small, even in this trailer itself, you will have some crane to lift and drop it. Or at the work site, you'll be having a tower crane from which you can lift the components and you can unload it. Next is the erection process. The process of erection and installation panels are like, we'll be discussing it. Before starting erection, any difference in dimensions or levels exceeding the tolerance, that should be first noted. A survey of the area to receive precast elements should be done first. Before erecting, you should measure the area in which your precast elements are going to be fixed. You should measure the elements size also before placing it. You have a crane mounted to this trailer itself, from which you are taking and you are going to load it at the work site. You see, this type of clamps are there. It will give you it will keep your elements in proper position. This is called the clutches. It will be like a hook type clutch. I mean, it will be like this. You might have having some keychains, right? It will be in this position. You can just, if you press on button here, it will be just opening. You can insert your ring here and you can just close it. That type of clutches, which is going to hold it. Procedure for transportation and erection. The second step is installation shall be done by tower crane with sufficient capacity. Panels shall be shifted from the stock rack or truck from yards to the nearest point of construction site and shall be kept above the truck during the construction. Or like when you're going to store it, you're going to unload and fix it in the construction site. The necessary access for the trucks to reach the nearest point of the tower means the tower crane here, shall be prepared before itself or before starting itself. You should plan accordingly where your trailer must come and unload it, where from which location your crane is going to come and lift it. All this should be planned before itself. Once the truck reaches the tower, chain and lifting clutch with required, you see, this is the chains. These are chains and clutches. The chains and clutches, it varies, depends upon the element, I mean your component size. If you are going to lift a huge solid floor, for that you should not go for a small clutch or a small chain. For that, you have different heavy lifting equipments that we'll be seeing in the last chapter. So we'll go step by step. As the elements are lifted to its final position above the cast in-situ slab or the precast slab, vertical and horizontal alignment should be checked. Remember, before you are unloading, you should be aware, before you're erecting, you should make sure that the surface is horizontal, your location is vertical, you're going to fix it. Also, when you're fixing a vertical wall like this, you are going to provide some additional supports till your grouting or you're fixing with the nuts and bolts is done, till that you're going to provide some props nearby. Shims and spacers shall be used for leveling and the adjustments. Temporary propping jacks shall be provided for restraining the wall from laterally under until grouting. I told you in the previous slide. Just a minute. Okay. After completion of fixing, alignment of the panel shall be checked again. Once you're going to fix, again you're going to keep your spirit level or your plumb bob and check for the verticality, whether it is vertical or your horizontal alignment is uniform. You're going to check it. Once you're checking, I mean, after checking only, you are going to fix it. Minor damages, if any, to the precast panels shall be repaired by the approved materials. If they're going to be slight chip outs or slight undulations are there, which is okay, then you are going to have some over either plastering or your cement grouting you're going to done, and you're going to close that floors. After completion of installation and alignment, elements shall be handed over for the inspection. The joints between the precast wall panels shall be filled with the joint filler materials. that is your cement slurries or your advanced grouting materials you can use to fill the gaps. Precast slab shall be erected above the wall panel without any scaffolding system. Over the wall, you have the wall here. Over this wall, you can place the slab without any scaffoldings. Because your walls are already done, you have your columns also as well. So definitely your slab will be bearing the support of this. The slab support will be resting on this wall and the columns. After electrical works are completed, screed concrete shall be done. Like once you have some openings for the electrical provision, once you are inserting your wires, your electrical wires for your provision of tube lights or your fans, once it is all done, you can close it with the cement paste. That is your concrete paste. With that, you can close it. It shall be provided over the precast slab. Shred concrete is nothing but it is a floor. Yeah.
Joint filler material. Can you explain something about that?
Joint filler material, that is nothing but your cement slurry. Yesterday we were seeing, when you are going to connect a column here and you have a column here, first you are going to fix it with the nuts and the sides. With the bolts, you are going to fix the sides. You will have some gaps exposed here. For that, you are going to provide some cement slurry. Which is nothing but it doesn't have any co-segregate. It will have only your fine aggregate. Fine aggregate is your sand, or river sand, or your M sand, water, and the cement. Only this mixture you'll be having. That paste you're going to provide in that location.
Yes. Will that joint filler material, that cement and cement mixture, will that bind to the precast material? Precast material is already hardened and strengthened.
No problem. This will get fixed because this cement slurry is all. If you are going with concrete only, then it will consume time. If you are going only for cement slurries, then it will get fixed to this. It will get bonded to the columns because already this is RCC only. It is made up of reinforced cement concrete only. So this cement slurry will get binded to the, the existing column or the walls. It will get binded. You don't have co-segregate, so it will get hardened or it will get set soon. So it will bind easily. You'll not find any.
Won't be any cracks forming at the boundary at the junction where the joint filler material is filled with and the. That precast prefabricated building component, will there be any crack as it hardens the joint filler material?
No, if you pack it tightly, there will not be any cracks or any undulations formed. You have to nowadays you are having shotcreting guns also. Like if you provide it in a force and also tightly packed, if you are tightly packing those filled area. Imagine this is the gap. You are going to tightly pack this without any voids. Then you will not have any cracks. Over that, you will be again having, if you go for either plastering or painting, that will not be visible even. Whenever you are going to remove this structure, you can, 1 minute.
Asking this because I have seen many times that whenever there is some breakage in the surface and the laborers come and apply the concrete there, after that concrete or any material, that cement paste is filled in that, and after drying up there is a crack developing at the interface, at the boundary of that filler material and the already hardened surface. That's why I was asking.
The thing is, people will not cure it after the grouting. We have to actually cure it after the grouting. If you see, okay. You have some surface here, like you are going to cover it with, you are going to patch it, you are going to do the patching work with the cement slurry. When we go for normal cube concreting or any type of concreting, we do cure it. But when masons come and do patch work, they'll just pour water for 1 or 2 days. They'll be just leaving it without even curing. That particular area, you should cure it. Only then it will acquire its complete hydration process. That should be completed.
Okay.
If you're not curing it.
So the joint, So the joint filler material with which the joints are filled, we have to cure it also in the prefabricated structure.
Yeah, you can cure it.
Okay.
Meanwhile, you can it will minimum of three days. That is enough because you are going to provide only cement slurry, right? You are not going to provide any coarse materials. So it is only fine material. 2 to 3 days curing is enough.
Thank you.
Okay. Any other doubts? Shall we proceed?
No, ma'am.
Okay. After yes, electrical works. Sorry, I completed this point. Sheet concreting. What is meant by sheet concreting is it is nothing but a patchwork of floor screeding, which is going to be made up of cementitious materials applied onto the precast concrete surface. Like you're going to cover that exposed gap with the concrete area. That is the sheet concreting. And next process in the erection is installation of the next floor shall start only after the completion of sheet concrete of the previous floor. The sequence of the erection shall be as follows. We'll see this sequence quickly. Am I running out of time? No, you have. Anyways, you don't have class right now. I have planned for a few more slides. Let me complete it. Yes, are you all hungry? What, ma'am? You are continuing the class in the lunch break also. Why, ma'am? You are torturing us like this. Yes, is that your mind voice?
Yes, ma'am.
What you are telling this frankly?
Okay. No, ma'am. This is not a torture, but yeah, we are hungry.
Okay. Then 1 minute. Let me check how many slides I have. Oh my God, I have still more 20 slides. Okay, let me stop with this slide then. Okay, we'll see this installation process alone, and I'll leave you. The sequence of erection is installation of the precast. Yes. Installation of precast wall panels above the slab you are going to fix the thing. And next, provide temporary props or jacks, which when you are providing the walls also, along its sides, you are going to provide some props so that it should not slide. Grout the connection between the wall panels and the ground. Now, this area, this is the ground level. This and this, you are going to grout it. And installation of precast slabs above the erected precast walls. Now, we are going to install the slabs. And then, screed concreting above the slab after placing of the electrical conduits fittings. Installation of the wall panels over. Once it is done, then you are going to go for the next wall panel. Likewise, this levels extends up to the top parapet wall. Till that, you will be continuing this process. And here you can see, here is a crane fixed where it is just erecting all this. You have some additional props here. Because it should not, this height is quite height, so I mean quite larger, so it should not slide along both sides. At the other side also, if you go and say, like props will be provided at the both sides. And also you can see a person is checking for the verticality. It should be vertical because only a man standing here is just operating, provided by the instruction of these two persons only. If it is going and fixing firmly, then they will be communicating them through wireless, and they'll be indicating them to stop it. Once they are stopping it, which means the location is fixed, then they'll remove these clutches. You can see these are the clutches which holds. Okay. Let me stop with this. Let me not continue too much in detail. That's all. We have covered a major portion. Only like how you are going to erecting the elements only is bending. So that we'll see in next class. Okay. You have any further doubts? Any further doubts?
No, ma'am.
Why today's class?